Hi, my name is Richard Revis. I'm co-owner of Black Jungle Terrarium Supply, and I'm here today on behalf of ExpertVillage.com discussing how to take your dendrobatted tadpoles all the way up through the froglet stage. At this point, we've hatched our tadpoles, and now we need to decide what type of container to house them in. Here at Black Jungle, we use two different methods. One is a communal rearing, and the other is a single tadpole per cup. The vast majority of our dendrobatids, including the Tinctorius, Azurius, Erotus, Leucomalus, and other related species, are all housed communally. Even though these species can be cannibalistic, we find that as long as they are not overcrowded and that they are fed regularly, then water change is done regularly, there's very few problems encountered by this. Just because of the sheer number of tadpoles that we can be dealing with at any given time, providing individual housing and individual sufficient volumes of water per tadpole are just too prohibitive to do them individually. The one exception is all of the thumbnail species that we do. Here, for example, there is a Dendrobates reticulatus tadpole. And any of these guys, whether they be the reticulatus, lamassae, ventrimaculatus, imitator group, any of those are all done individually. This is mostly due to the fact that these animals produce far fewer offspring than our larger species, and we want to ensure that they are all protected as much as possible. How you raise yours is entirely up to you, and there's a variety of different ways that can be done. Individually raising them are not a problem when you have enough time and space when you're dealing with a smaller volume of tadpoles. However, here we find that this is a very suitable substitution.